Hey guys, today I'm going to be going over the books I'm reading this winter. This is not actually a look for the video. My apartment is just not insulated. A lot of apartments in Japan are not. So I am chilling by the heater, which I'm still waiting to heat the room in its entirety up. So for the first little bit, I am going to be wearing this jacket because it is unbearably cold. Speaking of unbearable cold, I am really excited to talk about my winter TBR. I'm not doing a monthly TBR right now because books are a little bit more difficult for me to obtain right now. I have the ability to get them as ebooks and audiobooks, but I don't know which books I want physically. And so right now I'm just looking at this as a seasonal TBR, and then as I start to figure out my best buying methods, I will buy and act accordingly. As most of you know, I did just move to Japan, and while of course Japan has books, they are not in a language I can easily understand. They're in Japanese, I speak English, I am working on it. However, until my reading comprehension in Japanese is adequate, which will be years, I'm buying on Book Depository, getting ebooks, audiobooks, and having some of my older books sent to me over long periods of time. So again, seasonal just made a little bit more sense as far as keeping my goals in check. So the books on this list, I'm not entirely sure how I will be reading them this season, but regardless of that, I am super excited to read them. It is finally warming up in here, and I am ready to talk about my first book, which is my only book I currently own physically on my TBR. And that is Unravel the Dusk by Elizabeth Lim. I just talked about the first book in this series, Spin the Dawn, in my recent reads review. I gave it a 5-star, and it follows a girl named Maya who has the dream of becoming an imperial tailor, and when given the chance has to disguise herself as a male in order to enter a competition, which then smoothly goes into an epic fantasy with romance and a wizard. I absolutely loved this book. I'm really excited to start the next one. They look absolutely gorgeous together, and when I realized I needed to test my address out to make sure I could have books sent to me at this address, I knew it was going to be this book that I was going to have sent to me. So now it is here. My books can be sent to this address, and I have actually started on the first chapter because I couldn't help myself. I took this book out just to go and take pictures of it for Instagram, and I read the first chapter on the way back home. So I have pretty large expectations for this book, and I don't think it'll disappoint me. Next up is an audiobook I already own, and that is A Touch of Darkness by Scarlett St. Clair. This is a steamy fantasy romance taking place in a modern alternative universe with Hades and Persephone. Hades owns a gambling den, and Persephone is a goddess who has been hidden throughout history by her mother Demeter in order to protect her from her destiny. However, Persephone and Hades collide with each other, and the story begins. I do know the story of Hades and Persephone, but I'm really excited to see how this modern twist is, and I've been really craving to read about Hades and Persephone lately. This was on my November TBR list, and I just didn't get around to it because November was intense, but I'm excited to start it now, and I think it's gonna be a pretty quick listen. Next is Even the Darkest Stars by Heather Fawcett. This was actually a free book on Audible, free with my paid subscription, but it sounds incredibly wintry and is the beginning to a debut fantasy duology taking place in a wintry kingdom where the main character wants to become a royal explorer and map out the snowy mountainous empire as well as spy on its enemies. Don't know much more, sounds really good, definitely sounds like a winter read, and I'm excited to listen to it. Okay, after that I have 3 wolf books in a row. I don't know how this happened, it just did. We'll just see how this goes. But the first of these wolf books is The Girl in Red by Christina Henry. This is a dystopian sci-fi retelling of Little Red Riding Hood, and I don't know much more except for it does have content warnings for diseases and pandemics, so if you are feeling stressed about this dystopian world that you currently reside in, I don't know, it might not be for you, it might not be for me, but I am interested to see what a sci-fi dystopian Little Red Riding Hood looks like, so it ended up on the list. I also already have this Audibly. I don't know when I bought it, how I bought it, if it was on sale, but it was in the list of books I had not read yet, so I'm going to hopefully pick it up this winter. Next is a book that, again, was on my November TBR, and that is For the Wolf by Hannah Witten. For the Wolf has a girl that is being sacrificed. She is the second daughter, so she is sacrificed to the wolf or demons in order to bring their old ancient gods back, but once she goes into the forest to be sacrificed, she finds out more about these demons, or in particular, this wolf, and it kind of complicates the matter of if these immortal beings should even be returning, or if she is truly on the right side. It sounds like my cup of tea, to be perfectly honest. I really like these types of fantasy books, and depending on how I like the dystopian Little Red Riding Hood, this might be a totally different twist that's more up my alley. Last is not a Little Red Riding Hood retelling. It is a Hungarian historical Jewish mythology book called The Wolf and the Woodsman by Ava Reed. This has been on my TBR for a while. It is one of my 5-star predictions, and I just haven't gotten around to it. I haven't decided if I want to listen to it audibly, if I want to get it on ebook because the last time I checked it was on sale, or if I just want to bite the bullet and get the audiobook. All of these things have just had me procrastinating actually purchasing the book, but I really, really, really want to read it, so I'm going to be reading it this winter. I hope to actually make it really high on my priority list. We shall see. But a basic summary on this, though I have mentioned it before, is a woman in her village is the only one born without power or magic, so she is cast aside and is actually sent to be sacrificed to a king. On the road, her caravan is attacked, as all caravans on the road to a kingdom is, and she and a one-eyed captain have to actually flee, only to find out that they might be key to saving the kingdom or letting it be destroyed, as they have always been outcasts in the society and they have to decide how much they actually care about a world that has always discarded them. Next up is a pretty low priority read, but it's also really easy to read if I do get to it, and that is Down Among the Sticks and Bones by Seanan McGuire. And this is the second book in the Wayward Children series. I just finished the first one, but I'm trying to get out of the habit of starting series and then never completing them. I have so many unfinished series. It's making me really love duologies. Like, once I read this, that's it. I finished the series, and I don't have to worry about it anymore. I have finished all of these series, which makes this argument look ridiculous, but the point is that I have a lot of unfinished series. I made a video actually a little while ago, I'll stick it up there, where I go into unfinished fantasy series that I really want to finish. I haven't read any of those. I haven't finished any of those series, so this is a problem. I'm hoping to remedy that because it's such a short series of novellas that I think I can catch up. Down Among the Sticks and Bones is the second in the series, and I don't want to give away anything. So I'll say in the first book, we have a home for wayward children, or children who used to be in portal worlds, like wonderful fantastical worlds. And now that they are back in the actual world, they are having a hard time coping. And in most cases, they're not coping at all. They're just trying to get back to their wonderful world. Unfortunately, several murders begin to occur at this wayward children's home, and an already fantastical situation becomes that much more intense. I really liked the first book, and I'm curious to see where it goes, especially since it looks like these books can also be seen as standalones. If you've read the series, you'll have to let me know if that's true. It does say standalone when I was reading the synopsis, so they might have nothing to do with each other. I don't know what I'm talking about. I haven't read the book yet. Moving on. My wild card reads. These are books that I do have access to, sort of. If you have ever used the Libby app, you know that you kind of have to just jump on it as soon as your hold comes in. Because I am abroad, I was able to attach my library card to the Libby app, so I am still reading books from my library back home. However, there are holds on just about every single book I want to read at my library, and these books are no exception. Because I have to wait for them, I don't know if I'll actually get to read them this winter. It says 2 weeks, it says 6 weeks, you don't know, but at some point, it pops up in your app that your book is ready and you only have 2 weeks to read it. Notorious for procrastinating, I need to just drop whatever I'm doing and pick up these books ASAP so that I can get them done and read them for free, because we love free. The first book I am hoping to obtain from my library is Girls Made of Snow and Glass. Your hold is ready to borrow. Okay, this is what I'm talking about right now. It says my hold is ready to borrow. It said I had 2 weeks. Now I am starting Girls Made of Snow and Glass, and I have 14 days to read it. My videos never go as planned. This is by Melissa Bastardis, and is my most current read that I will begin reading as soon as this video is done, because again, only 2 weeks. I probably wouldn't have been as interested in reading this book if it hadn't been for Alexandra Roslin and her talking about it in her Cozy Reads recommendations. If you haven't watched Alexandra Roslin's channel, you just leave. Just go watch her channel.
Hello, friends, and happy day one of Vlogmas!
the most cozy place to be this winter, for sure, hands down. And in her Cozy Reads recommendation last year, she brought up this book and it sounded amazing. I don't know if it's amazing because she was talking about it or if the book is legitimately good, but it's a feminist Snow White retelling in which the Ice Queen and Snow Princess are somewhat friends or have a camaraderie between them. So it's not just a girl hate moment, but a complex stepmother-daughter dynamic. There's a couple different magical twists, such as having been cursed with a heart of ice and the princess being actually created from snow. It has a lot of whimsical magical elements. I haven't read a Snow White retelling in a while, if ever. I don't know if I've ever read a Snow White retelling, to be perfectly honest, and I'm really excited to try it, which is great because, again, I have to read it like now. After that is The Hunting Party by Lucy Foley. I'm gonna be real with you, this was also on Alexandra Roseland's last year's Cozy Recommendations video. I also have just seen it around places. I do not read enough thrillers, and I want an atmospheric thriller. I want something that I can snuggle up by said fire and read and just feel anticipation and angst. This sounds perfect as it takes place in Scotland at a resort. These friends all go on a trip and get snowed in together. Of course, one of them dies. And it has the potential for really good friendship dynamics. I love looking at human behavior, and I don't know why I don't read more thrillers, because they are truly fascinating to me, and I'm hoping that this winter I get into them and that this is my ticket in. After that is pretty much almost the exact same synopsis, but instead of a friendship group, it is a married couple having a lot of issues in their marriage, but they win a surprise trip to, you guessed it, snowy Scotland and get snowed in. This plot was actually really vague, but I did get a sense of a lot of tension, and whether someone dies or not, things are not going well for them, and I'm 1000% here for it. So those are the books I'm going to be focusing on this winter. That doesn't mean I won't pick up other books or possibly drop one off of this list if it's just not interesting me, but as of right now I have very high hopes, and I also want to know what you are reading this winter. Do you have a TBR for this December? Are you mood reading your way all through winter? What are your plans? I'd love to know them. Go ahead and put them in the comments below. And regardless if you do or not, I hope you're enjoying the sun or more stars wherever you are. And until next time, bye! Who's that by, Jade? Do you know? Did you bother? I don't even know. What am I talking about? Test to make my sure that I'm free with my prescription. Free with my paid subscription. Subscription. It's not a prescription. I'm not taking the audiobook as a medication. I mean, I guess you could say that, but like, that's a little too deep for the meaning of this video. Down among the sticks and bones. You can do this. If I hadn't have seen it. Am I saying words? Is that real? This is by Melisabeth Bastardus. I'm an English teacher, are we sure?